What's up, guys? FSC Trucking. We're going to get fuel here, and then we're going to get rid of this today. It's Friday. We're going to get rid of the dump truck, but first we got to get fuel because Orwell's thirsty. What's Orwell? Orwell's my 1984 Peterbilt. That thirsty son of a gun right there. And we got this garbage truck going to Hatley. We'll talk about it later. Let's get the fuel pumping. Let's get the video started. That's a reach. See if it makes it. Well, it stretches a little bit, it makes it. Hell of an offset. So while that's pumping, show what we got. We picked this up yesterday down in Georgia. Yesterday morning, actually. It's an old dump truck. Picked it up at an auction. Well, it picked it up at Harris County, which is where this is from. Harris County Garage, where they kept it, maintained it. It was bought at auction. We're bringing it up to Hatley, Wisconsin. Probably about a couple hours up the road. So there we go. Big old garbage truck. Oh yeah, gotta love it. The fun part was having this raise up so I could set it down on the back deck so it would clear. It's not all the way down. So we grabbed her by her trunnions with the chains, and then on the front we grabbed her by her front axle like I normally do. There we are. That's our load. Look at this thing just dripping away. Nice. That's my fuel. Ugh. Gotta love it. Well, what are you gonna do? That's just life. So here we are. Gotta do what we gotta do. Alright, let me watch this thing. These pumps are kind of fugazi. We'll deal with it.
check of some of my messages on YouTube talking about the truck show. Of course, by the time you see this, I'm pretty sure the show's already passed. But me filming is the future. Alrighty. Truck's full, belly's full. Time to get on down the line. Today's Friday, so I'm gonna kick this off today up at Hatley. It's a good guy up there. He'll take you whenever you get there. So I guess he don't live too far from his shop. So I call him and tell him I'm gonna be there. He'll be there. This one runs, so if I had to, I always could unload it and have him leave the paperwork out for it that I need for it when I need to bring to the yard. And the paperwork I have for him, I can always leave it with the truck, so I don't actually need him to unload. Down to the shop, put the trailer inside, and then tomorrow got a new mechanic coming in. Dave's got one of his buddies that also wants to work for me part-time, so I'll meet this guy for the first time, and Dave vouches for him, and I like Dave a lot actually. He's a real good experience. I think he's got great judgment, got a good work ethic. He had some issues when he changed jobs, his full-time job, so now he's unavailable this weekend because he's on the road with the new job out of state, so he's not available. But he's like, hey, I know a guy that's just as good as me. I'm like, all right, send him. So this guy will be here tomorrow, or at the shop tomorrow, and we'll get some work done. I'll put him on the trailer. Plan on servicing Orwell before I go to the truck show, so I can service Orwell. This new guy, I know his name, I just don't want to put it out there yet. He'll work on the trailer, I suppose. I'll see what he, see how he works, see how he does. I want to be at the show Wednesday night at the minimum. I meet some friends of mine that are coming down. Some are flying in, some are driving in. And see what other people I can meet while I'm out there. I kind of feel bad because I don't know everybody. And I think that it makes you feel weird when more people know you than you know them. It kind of adds a bit of weirdness to it, I'll just say. And I mean that respectfully. People come up to you, hey, how you doing? And I'm like, I don't know who you are. Do I know? Yeah, I'm a YouTuber. Oh crap, I never heard of you. But I don't live on YouTube. I work super, super hard, so it's just crazy. Yeah, maybe I'll get some extra time, or more time than I'm used to. I'm just not used to it. I did one before at Southern Michigan Railroad, and that was pretty cool. I enjoyed it, but it is a weird feeling when a lot of people come up and they want to meet you and shake your hand because they think you're cool. And I don't know, I drive a truck for a living. I mean, most of you guys do the same thing I do. I just have a different truck than most. But I get it, you know, I do have a likable personality. It's not like there's nothing about me to like, but being on this side of the camera is definitely a different feeling. Just leave it at that. I hope most people can understand that. But I'm very grateful for it. That's why I do stuff like that to meet and greets. I mean, it's a good thing. But I never want to lose sight of, you know, that people want to see me for whatever reason. So, and that's fine. That's excellent. I am with other people. So, works out in the end. Everybody's happy. That's what I want. Everybody be happy. Of course, I'm talking about things that for you are past tense, that for me are future. That gets weird. That's one of those time warp paradox type things, right? Back of the trailer. Hemp, rather, wallowing around in the mud.
And this one's got pretty good ground clearance in the center of the truck. I'll show you what I mean. So my thought process is we could back it off the back of the trailer, but I need, I'll use my ramps since I gotta move them anyway. I'll use my ramps to help the front wheels up. The back wheels, since they're drive wheels, they ought to climb up by themselves. Obviously after we raise the tail end. So, it's got a lot of ground clearance underneath. Shouldn't be an issue. So for now, we'll start off by, let's get it started. Turn the battery on, keys are inside it. Once we get it started, we'll unchain it. If it won't start, then I'll call him, he'll come over here with a jump box. That's one problem solved. You go ahead and get it unchained, get it backed off.